So Ohio State makes the jump to number two after a brilliant performance against Michigan State. Wolverines coming this weekend. Bama slips a spot. Cincinnati is up to number four. Michigan and Notre Dame are in the waiting room. Pleased to be joined by the chair of the College Football Playoff Selection Committee, Gary Barta. Gary, let's start with Ohio State's surge and the slight slip from Alabama. I've heard ad nauseum from people how the committee loves Alabama. But Ohio State, was it as clear-cut as it was to some of us if they had played their way into that two spot?
Well, two great teams, both Ohio State and Alabama. Both of them have Heisman Trophy candidates at quarterback. And this past week, though, the dominating win over Michigan State certainly got the committee's attention. The offense of Ohio State just total domination, and defense playing much better. And they've been playing better week after week. They now they beat Penn State, they beat Purdue. Alabama's still a great football team. Have a wonderful win against Ole Miss. The last few weeks, just not showing as much domination on defense. So two great teams, but when the vote came down, Ohio State came ahead of Alabama.
And once again, Cincinnati sets a high watermark for the highest-ranked team outside a Power 5 conference. Without looking ahead, what is the level of separation at the moment between Cincinnati and the teams you have ranked from the Big 12?
You know, I think most people have heard that we don't really talk about separation. We certainly talk about teams in clusters. Cincinnati, one of the things we've talked about all year is that win at Notre Dame continues to look better with every passing week. And this past week, the win they had against SMU, SMU came in 8-2, and Ritter just continues to show why he's one of the best quarterbacks in the country. Their defense is playing strong. So Cincinnati at four, the committee felt strongly about not really comparing them to the Big 12 directly. We don't look at conferences as much as we're looking at team by team.
Let me rephrase the question then this way. Is Cincinnati closer to being evaluated in the cluster with Georgia, Ohio State, and Alabama, or closer to being evaluated in the cluster with Michigan, Notre Dame, and Oklahoma State?
That's a fair question, a good way to ask it. And the honest answer is, when we were looking at clusters, we looked at Cincinnati both up with the 1-3, and we also looked at Cincinnati comparing to 5, 6, and 7. So they were compared to both groups, they ended up at four.
How they ended up by four at four easily, or ended up at four barely?
You know, we've had a lot of respect for Cincinnati all year. We certainly have talked about their strength of schedule. But this win against SMU, when we were looking at the way they played offensively and defensively, they came in at four. A lot of discussion. There's 13 members of the committee. There's certainly a disagreement at times. But when the vote came down, they were four and then Michigan at five.
The quietest number six that I can remember in all of the years of the College Football Playoff is Notre Dame. Notre Dame is likely going to go to 11-1 after beating Stanford this week. Their schedules let them down, candidly, in the preseason. It looked like a really aggressive one. A lot of teams have fallen short. How does the committee look at Notre Dame relative to its strength of schedule and how they're evaluated in those clusters against the conference, the teams playing for conference championships over the next couple of weeks?
Well, Notre Dame's been building momentum all year. They play terrific defense. Their offense has a lot of weapons, a lot of experience there. In the last few weeks, they beat Georgia Tech handily. Georgia Tech didn't look very good. They played Navy. They played some teams that maybe haven't helped their strength of schedule, but a terrific team. Notre Dame is highly thought of by the committee.
They've certainly improved. The schedule that you look at, the Wisconsin win at the time didn't seem so great because Wisconsin was 1-3, but they've gotten hot since then, and that win keeps looking better and better. Gary, thanks a lot for being with us. We'll do this one more time before the final rankings come out on Selection Day on the final Sunday.
Thanks, guys. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you. That's Gary Barta.